Hey, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's Azure Friday. We're here with Kirill Gavrylyuk. I always love having you on because you're so excited about your products, and they're always such great products.
Thank you, Scott. It was so awesome to be here every time.
My pleasure. So you've got Azure Cosmos DB, best name ever, but it's a new name for a familiar thing.
That's true, and it's more than just a rename. Many of you are familiar with Azure Cosmos DB. We've talked about a number of episodes. Mm-hmm. Thank you for your hospitality. Cosmos DB is the next generation of Azure Document DB, what we talked about previously. And it's the industry first globally distributed multimodal database as a service. Now, let me walk you a couple trends that brought us to launching Cosmos DB. First is that there is no single app out there anymore, or very few, that could lock itself to a single zip code. As soon as you launch your app, you may initially put your data in one of the regions or one of your favorite clouds, but very soon you'll discover that you have customers somewhere else, potentially around the globe on the other side. And latency, especially if you're doing multiple things on the same screen, you will see responsiveness going down like crazy, a couple seconds, several seconds, which becomes unacceptable. Mm. So you either need to invest a lot of engineering or you need a database that can bring your data to your users wherever they are. And there are very few of those. And none of them have this as a turnkey capability. Mm. And that's what Azure Cosmos DB brings. To this first pattern that we observed, we bring you a turnkey global distribution. And if I go to Azure portal and one of the Azure Cosmos DB accounts, mm-hmm. you can see that just with a single click on a map, I can add or remove a region. Mm-hmm. And it could be any number of them. Could be 30 plus, I think, the latest. And this combined with, you can set up your own manual policies or automatic policies for failovers. You can add and remove regions programmatically. You can have around the world clock. Mm-hmm. Where no matter where where's the most of the light of the day, that's where your right region is.
That would be cool.
Could be anything. In fact, this very portal, this very website that we are looking at, that uses Azure Cosmos DB.
Seriously?
Yes.
I did not know
For your user settings. And it's around the globe. And it's actually replicated in 30 plus regions.
Yeah, yeah. I love that this map, this is not a picture. This is real. These are the actual places that you're not here, you are here. And when you click those and hit save, it shows you which regions get updated. What's the difference between a write region and a read region?
That's a good question. So Azure Cosmos DB comes with two configurations. One is you have single write region. Hmm? Single write, multiple reads. In which case, you probably want to pick your write where most of the writes are coming from. We also have a pattern where you can build on top that where you can provide multi-write regions.
Oh.
Now, if you define a failover policy, for example, you chose Central US as your write region, mm-hmm. but then you can define a failover policy that will fail over to another region should there be a rainy day in Central US, mm-hmm. a meta-write hit, or just if you want to bring your write region to another set of customers that are currently active. Mm-hmm. You can fail over automatically, and all of this transparently to your application. Your application does not need to change. Even config doesn't need to change, which is probably the most exciting to me, is the fact that thanks to our multi-homing API, the app always knows where the nearest region is. Mm. It's very convenient. Mm-hmm. You can easily move your web tier anywhere for as many number of regions as you want, and it will find the nearest region where your data is. So that's one, right? That's global distribution. But there is more to it that we announced in Cosmos DB. And this is really new. It wasn't there with DocumentDB. Is this observation that over the last decades, there were many NoSQL databases.
There have been a few.
Yes. And every one of them is awesome in a particular use case that they're built for, mm-hmm. which is great. But we see customers now that use 3-5 databases in a single solution.
Right. They're using different databases because they think of the database now as being a tool in their toolkit,
yes.
but each one has a different API and a different management experience and a different thing that they're good at.
Exactly. And that was a valid approach. It's a great approach. Can I do your best in one particular scenario and really nail it? Except over time, we learned about it. And now we are at the point where we can solve this problem to customers and provide them. We can't shrink it to a single database, but we can shrink the number of databases you need. So instead of you getting one database for your key value pairs and one database for your documents, you can get one single database, Azure Cosmos DB, that gives you key value, white column family, documents, or graphs. And the cool thing about it is that you can access this data using different APIs at the same time for scenarios that it makes sense.
But let me like be super real for a second. It can't be the perfect ultimate cloud scale worldwide database, right? There must be something it's not good at.
Well, it's not good at relational data, for example.
Ah,
it is not a relational database.
So it's not SQL Server.
It's not a SQL Server.
Okay.
A SQL Server is awesome at having joins. With Azure Cosmos DB, you can get close, but it's not like you can't do random joins.
I see. And that's a good thing, because the reason that it's good at what it does is because of the way that it's structured.
Yes. It allows us to offer you this elastically scalable, infinitely scalable database service, which is very hard to do with relational database.
So what kind of questions do I need to be asking myself to know if it's right for me? What should my data be shaped like? What should my things look like? And I should say, oh, that's perfect. I should have put it in Cosmos DB all the time. I should move it out of database X.
I think it's if you're looking for sustained performance, it's really three variables, right? We call them three Vs. If your data changes a lot, no matter what shape of your data, whether it's key value, whether it's documents, your data changes a lot.
Right.
If your data is being ingested at really high speed, millions of transactions per second.
Okay.
Or if there's just a lot of data, if it's petabytes of data. Mm. Like these three Vs, this is where traditional relational databases, it's hard to do this.
Oh,
it's hard to do alter table.
You just described three very hard problems.
And this is what Azure Cosmos DB is great at, with the additional point that it doesn't matter what structure of your data is, whether it's key values or documents or graphs, it's good at any of them, as long as you don't do joins.
Okay, which makes sense. Yeah. And there are creative ways around that. But again, that might be a scenario where you might have a little bit of data in SQL and the rest of it in Cosmos DB.
Exactly. So we don't claim to be the single database of the world, but we're pretty darn close.
Yeah, and I appreciate that.
So let's get to, enough with slides, let's get to the demo. And the first thing I want to do is hit this point of multimodal, multi-API. Now, even with DocumentDB, we had the support for Mongo API. Mm-hmm. So let's start with a document database. Let's start by bringing an existing Mongo app.
Okay.
So I'm glancing at
the clock. And I've done that before, by the way. I can just tell people that it's amazing. I literally opened up Mongo Chef.
Yeah.
Took an existing Mongo application and copied it over to DocumentDB, and it just, or to Cosmos DB, and it just worked, and then the app doesn't even know.
Exactly. Well, let's try this. Let's actually do it, because not everyone has done it, and you know, folks usually are skeptical.
So this is an app out there that uses Mongo and Angular and Node.
Yeah, and I like it because it's a random app. It has nothing to do with Cosmos DB. You can find it by Googling, but it's a visual, and it has a reasonably sophisticated use of Mongo, meaning it uses Mongoose. It's a proper mean.
Yeah, this is not a Hello World application.
Exactly. So let's just clone it.
Okay.
I'm here. All right. And go to the folders that we get. Do npm install. It's a Node app.
Make it run locally?
Yep. Okay. And this app, by default, is connected to a Mongo Labs instance.
So they've already plugged it into the back end to Mongo Labs.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's see it run, right? So just to make sure that it exists. So it's on 300. On the ports. Oh, I need to actually run it.
You have to run it first.
All right, there we go. It's listening on 3000. Right?
Yep.
And it's talking to somewhere in EC2 to a Mongo Labs instance.
Right?
Okay. So let's take a look at the hit refresh and let's take a look at the code. Right here, I have main Google Maps folder, and inside the config, this is the one that it's talking to.
Okay.
And I already have, so first we're going to do is we're going to move the data. Using Mongo Chef tool, because you just mentioned it.
I love that tool.
So you see this connection string. This is a connection string that I already have Mongo Chef configured. Let's remove this one for now. I already have MongoChef configured, and this connected to that MongoLabs instance, and we have our Scotch users collection that this app is talking to.
Right.
Now let's create CosmosDB account. It's very easy to do. You just find it on the left nav. It's one of the top Azure services. You click Add. And it's the standard dialog. Notice that we ask you choose the API and a data model. And so you can use graphs with CosmosDB by using Gremlin API. Mm-hmm. You can use documents by using either MongoDB or SQL API, which was the original DocumentDB API. Or you can work with key value pairs, and this is using Azure Tables API, mm-hmm. also known to our customers. So in this case, we're going to select Mongo. Now, I already created this app, so let me just proceed straight to it. And when we create a CosmosDB account, we greet you with a quick start. I have a passion for quick starts, and I manage the portal team for CosmosDB. I think it's a good...
It is true. It is one of the nicest quick starts out there.
Thank you. Let's connect to it. And notice that this tool does not know anything about CosmosDB.
Right. It thinks it's talking to Mongo because you're lying to it, and it just works. It's amazing. Look at that.
In a way, right? So, and again, it's an empty, there are no collections, it's an empty database, as we know it. So this is, I love, and I think you actually is the one pointing me to this, right?
Yeah, isn't that great? Yeah,
You can go and copy a collection, and then you can paste it.
Yeah, I know. It's so funny.
It's just unbelievable, right? And it's doing it.
It's so funny. I spent all this time importing and exporting and doing all these important jobs in SQL Server, but with Mongo, you just drag and drop. It's beautiful.
So now let's take this connection string again and paste to our app, right?
So you're going to replace, you've just copied all the Mongo data over into Cosmos. You paste the URL there.
Yep.
Did you even change the port number?
I don't need because it's already part
it's
of
in the
connection.
URL.
Yeah, so it's going to get ignored. Let's just make sure this is what it's used, right?
Somebody somewhere will want that.
Yep. So let's do this here. Just to show that we're not faking anything, right?
Yeah,
it's actually CosmosDB.
I appreciate that.
And let's interrupt. I mean, this app does not restart, does not reload config and change.
Sure.
But let's restart it. And now this is working against CosmosDB.
Okay. Boom.
And it's loading, and data is there. So let's add the data. Let's add you. You look young.
Thank you.
And then let's do you like .NET. So let's store. This app just stores user data.
Sure.
It's not doing much. But now let's go back to our account. And with CosmosDB, you get it's very nice data management experience, right? So this is our collection. And right here, we have our documents. These are Mongo BSON documents. In fact, I can go and create an instance of Mongo shell right in the portal.
Wow.
And I can type DB. I can type Scotch users. Find, right? And type Mongo query. And we have a property age there, and I think we set 23. Right. And
a bunch of spam. All the other 23-year-olds.
Let's see.
That's fine.
Yeah. So you get somewhere there.
You have to go digging for me because the database is actually the live database. So what's important here is that if you already have a Mongo application and you can have it talk to Cosmos, it's going to get world scale. It's going to get all the features of Cosmos right off the bat.
Yes.
And in other videos, we're going to cover the table apps. We're going to cover the Gremlin API and doing all the different other kinds of data. This is just touching the surface and showing how easily you can take your existing apps that are Mongo apps, move them over to Cosmos.
Yep, precisely.
Very cool. We're just scratching the surface. We've got so much to share with you in other videos about Cosmos DB here on Azure Friday.